birthday coming up on Tuesday, and I just had to think about 2020, and I think about he didn't have to let me see. Some of my friends I went to school with, I just graduated 2 years ago, some of them are dead and gone, but I just said, thank you, Lord. It used to be when you got to a high number, y'all break it. It used to be when you got to 30, 35, 40, 50, you used to be able to praise him, but I'm going to praise him for 21. Because I didn't have to see. He didn't have to wake me up. And I want to say, thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. It ain't even here yet, but I'll praise him in advance.
Thinking about it. Do I have a few more witnesses that can think about it?
And I don't know if this stage is 6 feet, but it just ain't room enough for me. I don't know if you got 6 feet distance, but I can just tell somebody that ain't enough for me. You ought to wave at somebody and say, that ain't enough for me. I need a little room. I need a little room to praise him.
Some birthdays ain't got here yet. I
see just a few of y'all. Now you ought to praise him in advance because you can make it to your birthday. You ain't got that yet. But you ought to praise him and say, Lord, I want to make it. Lord, I want to make it.
Father, that God, we glorify you, we honor and we praise you. For this is the day that you have made, and we are so glad and happy to be here. We thank you for your sunshine and your cool breeze. Lord, we love you today. We magnify you, for you are worthy, worthy to be praised. Now, Lord, as I bring a word, we pray, God, that somebody give their heart to Christ today. We pray somebody hear a word, an encouraging word. In the name of Jesus, we say, let the words of our mouth, meditation of my heart, be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my great redeemer. Thank you, God. We're going to move on to the word of God, very familiar scripture, and I'm going to do the best I can before the rain comes. We're going to invite you to the book of Exodus, the third chapter, very familiar word. Third chapter, and we're going to commence reading at the sixth verse. Moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. And the Lord said, I have surely seen the affliction of my people, which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters. For I know their sorrows, and I am come down to deliver them out of the hands of the Egyptians, and to bring them out of that land unto a good land, a lodge, unto a land flowing with milk and honey, unto the place of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, and the Hebites, and the Jebusites. God bless you, and I'm going to move to the 12th chapter of Exodus just to read a couple of verses, if you don't mind. Chapter, the 30th verse, and it reads thusly, and Pharaoh rose up in the night, he and all his servants, and all the Egyptians, and there was a great cry in Egypt, for there was not a house where there was not one dead. And he called for Moses and Aaron by night, and said, rise up, and get you forth from among my people, both ye and the children of Israel, and go serve the Lord as ye have said. And just for your edification, and I will read Psalm 30 and the latter part of the fifth verse. And it states, weeping may endure for a night, but joy, I said joy, First Lady, they are doing well. They're in this sabbatical, and God is bringing them on through it. We thank God for an opportunity to be here. Amen. We honor my mother today also. Praise the Lord. I want to use for a theme today. God will turn your midnight into praise. Blow your horns if you believe that. Every phase of life, every walk of life, upside upside down. The virus has caused people to lose their jobs, lose their homes, lose their cars. Schools are closed. Am I right about it? Churches are closed. 40,000 airline folks have been furloughed. That's a lot of people. The economy is in a bad situation. But I come to let you know that God will turn your midnights into a praise. Family and friends, relationships have been turned upside down. The virus has caused unnecessary sickness, unnecessary death of loved ones. You say, why I say that? Because there is a failure of national leadership. Somebody dropped the ball. Here today, we are facing hatred, racism, and Jim Crow is raising his ugly head. Are you in the building today? Seem like communities are turning on one another. Not here, but in Portland, in Minnesota, in Kentucky. Communities are on an uproar. Are you here today? They are divided because of Jim Crow laws. Jim Crow is raising his ugly head. Yes, it is. Some folk are trying to cause us to revert back to the 50s. Are you in the house today? We have voter suppression, all types of things. But I submit to you today, church, that midnights are just a test. It's a test of our faith. Midnight draws closer to God. Are you here today? Midnight causes us to pray. Midnight causes us to seek the face of God. Troubled times don't last always. Tough times make tough folks. Are you here today? Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. As we look at our text today, we discover that the children of Israel have found themselves in a midnight crisis. They are experiencing troubling times, oppressive times. We are experiencing troubling times, oppressive times. The Bible is somewhat repeating itself. Anything that's going on now has pretty much happened in the Bible. Yes, it is. As history tells us, Jacob and his family were invited to move from Canaan to Egypt because there was a famine in the land. The water had dried up. There was no food to be found. But Jacob was invited by his son, Joseph. Joseph was the first son of Jacob and Rachel. Are you here today? The Bible allows us to know that he had been sold down in Egypt. He was sold to a caravan of Ishmaelites for 20 pieces of dirty silver. Money make people act a little funny. I can't hear no horns. However, Pharaoh and Joseph, the first Pharaoh, they loved the children of Israel. They gave them the best of land, the best of food, the best of animals, the best of water, and told them to go ahead and make yourself at home. But Joseph died. Pharaoh died. And another Pharaoh rose up. This Pharaoh didn't know Joseph. This Pharaoh didn't care about anything. He didn't care about anybody. He didn't have any compassion. He didn't have any empathy. Does that remind you of anything? He was all about himself. Pharaoh thought he was a little god of the sun gods. But he didn't know he was about to run into the real God, the big God, the supreme God, the superior God. He didn't know that God had all power in his hands. The second Pharaoh had the children of Israel enslaved. He had them whipped by them build pyramids. He made them build buildings. He caused them to build false gods. But God was sitting high and looking low. Yes, he was. The Israelites were in trouble. He told the midwives, I want you to kill the firstborn boy of the Israelites. But the midwives didn't pay them any attention. They acted like they missed the mark every time a boy was born. He tried to upset the Israelites. But the children continued to pray. The Pharaoh didn't like the Israelites. They were multiplying. They were growing more than the Egyptians. Pharaoh was afraid of the Israelites. He thought that they would rise up and kill them. He thought they would rise up, black people, and take over America. Are you in the house today? He thought those Spanish people were going to rise up and take them. You know I'm right today. Just like in the Bible day, we have a Pharaoh sitting on 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. He's trying to take us back to the 50s, but I believe the storm is about to pass over. I believe God is about to get involved. He's not going to let him have his way, but for so long. God was sitting high, and he heard the children of Israel. He heard their affliction. He heard their cry. He saw their sorrow. He saw the oppression. And God called a man by the name of Moses. He said, look at him, Moses. I want you to go down to Egypt. I've been looking at Pharaoh. He thinks he's big and bad. He's just a little counterfeit God. We got some counterfeit God running around America. But God is sitting high, looking low. He said, I want you to go tell Pharaoh to let my first son go. Let my firstborn go. I'm going to lead them to a place flowing with milk and honey. Are you here today? Let us observe right here. God said, I heard a cry from the children down in Egypt. The Bible tells me in Psalm 18 and 6, in my distress, I called upon the Lord and I cried unto God. He heard my voice. His in his temple, and my cry came before him, even in my ears. Have you ever had to cry out to God for a loved one? Cry out to God for a sick person? Cry out to God for your own home? Cry out to God for your family? God said, I heard the voice of the Israelites. I heard my children. He said, I saw the affliction. I saw the pain. I saw the distress. I saw grief. And I saw misery. But oh God, God won't let you cry but so long. He won't let you holler but so long. He said, look ahead in Psalm 25 and 8. He said, look upon my affliction and my pain and forgive all my sins. God is sitting high, looking at you in your pain, looking at you in your affliction, and he feels your affliction. Can I get a witness up in here? Throw your heart if you hear me. Look at him, Moses. Go down. Tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Go down, Pharaoh. Tell Trump, His name. We got to lift Him up no matter what you're going through. The Bible said, if you keep your mind stayed on Him, He'll keep you in perfect peace. Somebody needs to put your mind on Jesus. He loves you. I said, weeping may endure for a night, but joy, joy, come up in the morning. God said, look ahead, Moses. I'm going to send some plagues on Mr. Pharaoh. I'm going to send 10 plagues on him. Let him know that I am God. Let him know I have all power in my hand. God sent the first plague. He turned the water into blood. He sent flies, sent hail, sent our nets. But the last one, He told Moses, I'm going to take Pharaoh's son. I'm going to kill all of the firstborn boys all over the land. I'm gonna kill his children, and he gonna let my people go. Don't you know when somebody mess with your children, you feel hurt, you feel pain, you feel disappointment, but look at him. God killed all of the Egyptian children, but God didn't kill the Israelites. He said, get out of here. Take these people. Take your animals. Move. Move. Go serve your God. I stopped by and let you know. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy, joy.
Oh,
as you approach the city, you will see a man that's carrying that picture of water. He said, and when you see the man, tell him, the master has need of your guest chamber. Tell him we want to prepare for the Passover. And they went and did as Jesus said. And when the Passover was, meal was prepared. They sat at the table. No doubt Jesus was talking to the disciples. After all, they had walked with him almost 3.5 years. Perhaps he reminded them of some of their conversations, some of the commandments, some of the do's and don'ts, how to carry themselves. But Jesus said, one of you fellows are going to betray me. And everybody started to look around, exceedingly sorrowful. And they asked the question, Jesus, is it I? Jesus said, it is the one that didn't exist with me. It is he that will betray me. Judith is Carol, a low-down thief, who betrayed Jesus for 30 pieces of low-down silk. He asked Jesus a very profound question. He already knew the answer. He said, is it I? Jesus said, thou hast said. The Bible tells us Jesus picked up the bread. And he blessed it. And he said, this bread is my body. His body was given for you. It was given for you. It was given for you. It was given for all of God's children who accept him as his own Savior Jesus Christ. He break it and he said, let us eat.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, Jesus is the name.
already been stated. The benediction has already been stated as our deacons and trustees are coming. Brother Johnny Frazier here will be standing for the preacher. Brother Huff and the deacons will be standing on the side of him for the church offering. Brother Johnny Frazier here in the middle will be standing for the preacher. And the deacons and trustees will be standing on both sides of him for the church offering. Now, if you have enjoyed yourself, somebody ought to wave their hand and say, thank you, Lord. Somebody ought to wave their hand and say, thank you, Lord.